Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Connor. I'm here with my father,
Kevin.
Before we get started going into the album, we got some big news for you guys. We have started a Patreon where you can see all the albums that we do going forward, completely unedited, uncut. So no skips and pauses throughout anything. You'll be able to listen to the full song.
They'll be able to see like some of the like the weird stuff that happens. I do.
Yeah, anything that we say that's weird that we're like, oh, we shouldn't put that on YouTube. That's it might be weird.
Like the ball scratching and stuff?
Ball scratching, anything like that.
They're gonna see all that.
Yeah. Wow. So all unedited on Patreon for $3 a month. We don't make any money off the videos we post on here because of the copyright music. So if you want to support us, that directly supports us and gives us more funds and time to
make these videos.
Yeah, make these videos. Yeah. And we appreciate all the support. But saying that, you don't have to subscribe to the Patreon. The videos are still going to be coming out once a week on here. And they'll be in the same type of format. Just if you want the unedited version, then you can go on to Patreon if you feel like. And today we are doing Kid Cudi's second studio album, Man on the Moon, number two, The Legend of Mr. Rager. What do you know about this album?
I know nothing about this album, but I'll tell you, I'm so excited for this album because after the first time I heard Cudi and then I heard Cudi and Kanye together, mm-hmm. I'm a huge fan. I'm like stalking him.
Yeah, but you follow him on Twitter and
Instagram, stuff like that. The problem with that is that I don't want to screw up any of this, mm-hmm. so I have to shy away. So I just look at stuff, and then if there's something that pertains to something, you know, something new, yeah. I stay away from it and I wait for this. So that's the hard part about it. So any of the stuff we've explored, I can go back and listen to and watch, right?
Yeah. So you've been excited to do this since we did the last Cudi record.
I'm really excited. And this is the one that I think I meant to say that you had in the bedroom.
Yeah. I was going to say this album has a lot of history in this household, because mm-hmm. This was the first album I bought on vinyl when I was...
Very, very first?
Very first album.
Oh, wow.
When I was like 14 or 15.
Yeah.
Before I even had a record player.
Yeah.
So...
Wow.
It's been sitting around the house for a long time, and you've seen it.
I've seen it all over the place. It's like, again, back to that other one about Cudi being your family. I think you you moved it around with you.
Yeah,
you'd go downstairs, there would be the album. You go to the bathroom, you go upstairs, you'd outside, the bed. Album would be laying
cuddly. It would be beside me on the pillow.
Who is this guy?
When you listen to Man on the Moon 1, do you get that feeling of comfort that
completely
and like Reborn and stuff and those tracks,
all those tracks? You know, I was out doing some building a fence and I had it on my headphones. And I still get the shivery feelings mm-hmm. when I hear that album. It's neat. You know what's cool is that the first time we listened to it, it made an impact on me. But like 8 listens in, mm-hmm. it's still doing the same thing.
Yeah,
it's still making me feel special. I feel like he's like
talking to you.
No, I feel like he's like my father. Yeah, it's happening now.
Yeah, it's happening to you. Yeah. Okay, you ready?
I'm ready when you're ready.
Track number one, Scott Mescudi versus the world.
What up? How's everyone doing? You are now in the world I'm ruling. Take a minute to adjust for the wonder us. Clusterfuck of fun enchantment. I promise you some generation next shit. Speak for the seller who are left with parallel levels in the dark place. Tricked all you niggas to a dark fate. And guided you all with a smile up on my face. It's the sun, cause it's us on the floor. It's gently gentle with the drugs. Heavy with the love. My speeches on stage. Rock moms from a club. Money doesn't move me except in a literal bitch.
He didn't stop with his hooks, did he?
No, well, it's CeeLo, but it's still great.
Yeah. He probably wrote it.
Yeah.
He wrote that, right? Again, what a mix, man. How's everyone feeling? I hope you
understand what you're hearing. Take a minute to a love for the wondrous. Clusterfuck the darkness and evil. I will pay the yin and the yang for you. In my jeans of Dior for the lover skinnies. Upgraded, faded, it to the T. Work hard, making sure I don't become a memory. Hard to press on when the memories remember me.
Is this a bit of a look back at like where he's come?
Yeah. Where he's come from and where he is now.
Where he is now, yeah, okay. Oh, I love that. Yeah. I love those breaks there. Where they break it down just to
slows down a little bit.
Yeah, just to shift it. That's a great opening track.
Yeah, so track one.
I really got the feeling of what's going on here.
Does this start off darker, would you say?
Yeah. From the perspective of like, in the lyrics here, where it was like... maybe they were never meant to be acquainted. Money seems to, you know what I mean? All that is like that sort of getting like, you know, jaded, like, you know, what's going on here type of thing. Is that what I'm...
Yeah, so this album was kind of after the success of Man on the Moon.
Yeah.
Going on tour, living that, you know, the famous type of life that he was adjusting to.
Yeah.
With a bunch of... So his mental health issues... carried from the last record, but this is just enhanced with a lot of drug use, and it was a very dark period in his life, so you'll start to see that as we go further into the album. But as an intro, how do you
I like it. I really like it. It's orchestration's fucking beautiful. It's amazing. The mix is good, and CeeLo's part, it's another hook. I think he must have Scott must have wrote that.
I don't know. I'm not going to say for sure. Because
I'm just saying because he's just a master of the hook.
Yeah.
Right? It's like, it's so catchy, right?
Yeah. Track number two, Revofev.
Yeah. Welcome. Welcome you. Hey. I'm your big brother.
Oh, some electric in there.
What do I have to say to the kids? Let go, life does get tough. No need to stress, hold you back too much.
There he is.
Yeah,
he's got him.
Might get rough, no need to stress, keeps you down too much. Wake up, I heard they found a solution. Well, where will you be for the revolution?
This is the cocaine area, I guess.
So and I like it. Hey, I am happy today. This night like other days. I feel okay.
Yeah. Whoa, whoa. I love the rasp in his voice there. That,
I know. Whoa. It's so beautiful.
Yeah. Whoa. I'm your big brother. Where will you be for the revolution?
Cool.
Yeah,
I was just gonna comment before. I love those military drums right in there.
Yeah,
it's like with revolution and then. He's got such a cool voice, man. Like, you know, really, like, it's, you know, I think there's nothing he can do with his voice. Like when he's doing the
nothing
the,
he can't do.
I can't do, yeah. Nothing he can't do with his voice. Like, he hits some sweet things. He can sing high. He's got all over the place, right?
Mm-hmm.
But this really, it's it really speaks to you in terms of like in terms of like what's the anxiety.
Yeah.
Right? As I'm reading it, I'm going, geez, okay, I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm not going to stress out. You know what I mean? No need to stress. Keeps you down too much.
Yeah.
It's so, I'm getting choked up. See that?
Yeah.
No, good track. It's a good track. Did you, at the time, when you first heard this, I'm going to just throw this at you. When you first heard this, did it, when you first listened, you went through it, did you go, fuck, this is speaking to me?
It did, but it's changed its meaning as I got older.
Really?
You know? Well, because, I mean, looking, like, as a kid listening to this, the lyrics were kind of just, I read them in a simple way. I processed them very simple, you know? What was I stressing about at 10 years old? Probably not much.
Yeah.
But as a 10-year-old and 11-year-old, you know, in my brain, I connected with that. Now I still connect with it, just my problems are a lot, you know,
different
and more heavy, but you know, so I did resonate with it when I was younger,
for sure. Okay, good,
just in a different way. Track number three, Don't Play This Song.
I love the mix of it. I was a grape cigarillo man.
My mom's calling, think I see a decline. I'm numb face while I'm thinking about suicide. Don't with the sign, like when I'm not on drugs. Please don't play this song. Ride, trying to get my mind, ride. Low, don't take no shit, you can blame my mom. I'm in the maze, I'm in the days, I'm losing
wow.
it.
I just love his phrasing.
Feels like things can be covered until the day I'm above myself hover. Wanna know what this sound like when I'm not on drugs. Please don't play this song.
I love the orchestration.
Yeah, I was going to say a lot of orchestration on this record.
I know, tons. Yeah, it's like, but the way he had the orchestration, and then he had just an like a synth, the synth two, bass. Like yeah, like it's the mix was really cool. There's Mary going at it, not going at it, singing.
Okay, and that's Don't Play This Song.
That's a good track.
Yeah.
Very good track. I like it. I like how he really opened up
about where
everything
where he's like, at in life.
This right second now. Verse here, the whole this the way they're talking, right? People are talking about on the blog says Cuddy's lame, wearing a kilt, he must be gay. This whole thing here.
Yeah. He got sponsored, I think, by Vitamin Water and he was on HBO, so that's if you were wondering.
I was gonna wonder, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what it was, yeah.
And something about money to blow, that's money for blow or something.
Yeah, that's money to blow because it's money for blow. Yeah, it's definitely going through shit here, eh?
Yeah. Well, I mean, we watched the part of the Joe Rogan interview with him, right? And remember he was talking about how he, just to function, he would wake up, he would do a line of coke in the morning, drink a beer, and then smoke weed just to be
even keeled.
Yeah. And, wow. And that was the only way he could go out and do stuff and talk to people.
Shit, man.
So this is basically we're living through that time period of his life. Jeez. While listening to this. And yeah, it's dark and it's very emotional. But his wordplay on this song is fantastic. I love it a lot.
You know, it's you're telling me that and we watched the video and I'm thinking about it now and I know more about Cuddy now from listening to interviews and just following him and stuff like that. It's amazing to see where he's, where he was and where he's at now. Like, you know, I mean, just in terms of like we talking earlier, I flipped through his Instagram and stuff, and he's out doing things and stuff like that. And again, I don't know how he's doing mentally, but he looks happy.
He looks happier. Yeah, for
right, sure. So I didn't see him before, but he just looks happier. But, yeah, no, it's crazy what the people go through. And then what's amazing is that
put that into
this.
Yeah.
Right. Like I would be, you know, I'd be twitching somewhere doing, you know what I mean? I just couldn't sit and go, I'm going to go into the studio and put all my feelings down.
Yeah.
Like that's hard to do.
No, kudos.
Right.
Kudos to Cuddy for that.
Yeah.
I just want to mention again, the wordplay on this. I love, you've mentioned it, like the raspy tone to his voice.
Yeah.
You know, it's got like a smoky
kind of the bottom end stuff. Yeah.
Down feeling to it. And, just the first few lyrics on that track is just so great. Pain, hurt, sadness, and loneliness. Bottle that shit right up.
Yep,
toss it away to the bottomless pit. A part of my mind so sick. I only like to take the trip unless I'm sloppy drunk. That
was close to a rap right there.
Yeah. If I did a little faster and a little more on beat. Those bars just fucking hit me like when I was younger. I mean, I wasn't into drugs or alcohol as a kid, but just hearing that and just like, you know, this guy's so just open about this stuff, and it's like it just makes you feel, you know, like you connect with it.
I wonder where my vodka was going then all those years.
Yeah.
I always assumed it was you when you were 10.
Yeah, that was me. This track is titled We Ite, Wake Your Mind Up, and then it goes into Marijuana.
Okay.
That's the next track. It's only it's about a minute long, so we'll just play.
Wow,
this one.
Yeah, okay, yeah,
the Weite.
Yeah.
So we'll just play that, and then into Marijuana. You like that? Yeah.
Wow. Say it again, the mix is getting wicked. This is
I be on it all day, like my nigga big boy said. That's the only thing that keep me level up in my crazy ass. Don't on the run. No fun if not, it's scary from the email red.
Oh, wow.
The mix is incredible.
Oh, yeah, it's like that there?
I think it's a guitar.
Is it?
Yeah.
Super fuzzed.
Yeah.
It's got some wah, but it's the treble's gone. That's cool, eh? Oh, I like that. Wow. What were you doing this track when you were 10 years old? I I'm loving this guitar with everything, man.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
It
fits the track so well.
It does. And because it's got the treble gone, like it's making it better.
Yeah.
If the treble was out and it was irritating your ears, but it's sort
it fits in the
mix. Nicely more
cool, right?
Yeah. So this track is right there. It ends at 4:10, but
yeah.
He keeps it going until
4:20.
Wow.
And 4:20.
that's cool. Eh?
Yeah.
I like everything about that track.
Mm-hmm.
I want to say that it's. He takes something like there's a bit of melancholiness about it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know what I mean? Cause now that you told me what he was going through, that he needs the weed, right?
Yeah.
At the time. And then you have this really, really beautiful song.
Mm-hmm.
Like it's this real mix. It's weird to feel, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Cause it's so dark, but it's so beautiful.
It's so beautiful. Yeah. And it's, you know, pretty green, but, and then you're like, but I mean, it really just speaks to what you told me now. Right.
Mm-hmm.
Converse covered with mixer juice, right? A gray goose. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful track.
It's catchy too.
It's super catchy. It's super, super catchy, right?
Okay. We'll go on to the next track. This is titled Mojo So Dope.
Didn't hang in the skinny jean wear a fro for days in the OAA. Low. Most fools couldn't price me, silent stunt with a blunt full of PE. And I guess you know me, been in NY so long. Gotta trust they family, especially Brooklyn. Shout out to the Mahdi's. My bloodline runs deep, nice I don't sleep. Figure it's my pops keeping me away. Him to keep my mind at the clouds for reality. These motherfuckers can't fathom the wizardry. Slow mo brain ass backwards cowards. Shower, your attitude stinks, soon to know what I think.
Oh, oh, oh.
Hey, my mojo so dope, bitch. Became the A's, the even rage. I was drowning my sorrows with some OE, nigga. Hey, we live this shit.
Oh, oh, oh.
Hey, this is really,
my mojo
wow, it's
so
just really
dope, bitch.
Deep.
My yeah, mojo you're so reading super into deep. Lyrics and stuff.
Yeah, yeah, wow. Am I getting him confused? But did he lose his brother?
His father.
Oh, his father. Okay, okay.
We live this shit.
Oh, oh, oh.
Give a fuck about your lifestyle. Give a fuck about a motherfucking lifestyle, nigga.
Yeah. Oh, 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 oh.
Give a fuck.
Simple super on the easy on the music again, eh?
Yeah.
Like very, very simple on the music so that the lyrics just come out and just...
Yeah, there's not too much going on instrumentally.
No, just that organ and that's it.
Yeah, and the drums.
And the drums like that. That's it. Wow, it's he's really fucking letting shit out, eh?
Yeah.
Like in this song especially, like particularly like about him drinking and... So there, I know he left, he's right here he's talking about his... wish that I could tell my brother. Was that...
I don't know. Maybe he... I don't know if... I'm not going to...
Something from the motivation, get it out of that gutter. He's leaving behind a family and a mother. Damn, you must understand when I speak of in this home. I know, but I know his dad did pass, right?
Yeah, his dad passed at a young age.
At a young age, right?
But I don't know in terms of... I don't want to butcher anything.
No, assume stuff.
But
no.
But yeah, the lyrics really, really carry that track, and it's... It's an emotional one, just in terms of his storytelling. Like you're kind of, the beat is nice, the instrumental's nice, and the hook by I think it says the guy's name there.
Fridolin Nords.
Yeah, I believe it's a sample of
Fridolin Nords. Yeah,
of that person's song.
Yeah,
so he sampled that vocal to put it into the song.
Yeah,
and you know you're not too like in the track Marijuana.
Yeah,
you know, there's. instrumentation is so beautiful.
Yeah.
And it's going on. And so you're really paying attention to that. This, you're like really just tuned into what he's saying. And
which, you know what, that's, I'm now on the second listen. I don't mean to jump people, but Frank Ocean, I've listened to Frank Ocean now. And the first time I was like, where's the music coming in? When's this coming in? All this kind of stuff. I've listened to it now and I'm like, I get it.
Yeah.
It's like, it, keep it simple, stupid. Right.
And you listen to what he's
saying. And you listen to what he's saying. And it's like, I'm not waiting. Like, I'm not waiting for any drum, no beat to drop or anything. Yeah. I just enjoy it. Right.
Mm-hmm.
And this was simple that way too. It was just like, really listen to the lyrics. And on that one, I could have probably dropped the lyrics on it. Like, you know, certain ones. I find Cuddy is fairly, his enunciation and his flow, right?
Pretty easy to
go, right?
Yeah.
I like to read it so I really feel something the first time, right?
Yeah.
But it's really very easy to follow.
Next track is titled Ashton Kutcher.
Not Ashton?
No, I think it's a play on Ashton Kutcher.
Oh, is it?
Ashton Kutcher.
Okay, the Kush is the weed. Yeah. Ash is the ash.
Yeah, when you're ashing it.
Yeah, yeah. That's, yeah. Okay.
Okay, we'll get into it.
First things first, been ripping, get it in cutter. Niggas know the name is none other. I know you know me, the 00 rapper. Two stepper gun, toto nana, smoke kusher. I know you loving that, I do it when I switch up the lizang. Kutwa, I'm climbing and I know why. Y'all know I keep it funky, motherfucker. Better get it right, get it right.
That first verse was wicked, this is wicked. There's a few things I don't understand at all in the first one. I'm gonna have to look up. This is catchy as fuck, this one. This is really good, man, this chorus.
Hey, doing what I want, no need the front, skinny and tatted the fuck up. They pass me the blunt, baby, get up. We in this bitch Lexin, Dennis know the game. He in the crowd macking, all up on the dome. No need to pin it, friend. Me and my nigga be getting ends again. Told my man playing bad dog ever since day one. We gon' get it poppin', that's what I'm in for.
Here it goes. You said I wouldn't dance. Okay, yeah, I like it. This is... I love it. How he's flowing this stuff.
His inflections.
Yes.
Okay, yeah. You can dance to this one.
Yeah,
I forgot about this track.
Yeah. Wow, the vocals and the oohs are... Look at the ooze. The fucking ooze. How can one do ooze like that so good?
I don't know, man. He's a legend.
Wow. There. It's okay. I like that track. That is... Sorry, I had to scratch my nose there. That is a fucking bomb track. Wow.
You can say banger.
Banger. Can I say banger?
Yeah.
Can I really?
Yeah, that's what the kids would say nowadays.
Yeah.
It's a banger.
Oh, that's a banger.
Yeah, the chorus is catchy.
I was just going to say, it was totally different used when I was younger, right?
What was banger used?
What are you going to do with her?
I'm going to bang her. Okay, yeah. Maybe don't use banger then. I don't know.
Okay, that was a banger. Was bomb old?
Oh, bomb works. But you'd say that track was the bomb.
Oh, that's okay. What did I say?
You said it. Maybe you said that. I don't know.
That track is the bomb. Anyways, the track is the bomb. Seriously, when it opened up, like the flow on this was like fantastic. There was a bunch of shit I didn't get.
Oh yeah,
like it was. No,
there's a lot of slang and stuff.
A lot of slang that was totally over my head. I don't even know what it is, but you know what? sort of, it didn't matter.
Yeah, because you're just so into it.
Just so into the flow and feeling when someone does that good, when they're really, really fucking good at it, it's just, it's magic. And I have to, I'm really, really converted over to hip hop.
Yeah, you've got a newfound respect for hip hop.
Great hip hop, good stuff, right? Mm-hmm. I haven't heard anything yet. I think somebody said play some real, somebody mentioned on one of the socials to, for you to send me, I forget what they called it, but anyways, it was some term of hip hop, and then you can see what this, how good this is, right?
Because mm-hmm. Like they wanted to show you shittier hip hop,
yes.
So you can, I don't know if I will do
so
that.
So show shitty hip hop, so I can see where this is at. But you know what? I don't know if I want to. You know what I mean? No.
There's enough good hip hop out there to just keep going and listen to it. So
I got a bunch of shit on this track. Okay, chorus is fucking the bomb, right?
Yeah,
the bomb. It's fantastic. It's catchy. The oohs and the ahs. The verses, his flow is just, and the inflections, the way he does things, and then suddenly just fucking jams a word up, right? And just at the end of something, it's so good. That was a great, very, very good track, man.
Moving on to track number 8. This track is titled Erase Me, and it's featuring our boy, Mr. West.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, let's get into it.
Wow, what a snare.
Yeah.
She said I don't spend time like I really should. She said she don't know me anymore. I think she hates me deep down. I know she does. She wants to erase me. A couple days, no talking. I see my baby, and this is what she tells me. She said, I keep on running, keep on running, and nothing works. I can't get away from you.
Oh, wow, a falsetto.
Yeah.
Oh my god, crazy.
It's like I'm her new nightmare. Soon delete. A couple weeks, no talking. I see my baby.
Magazines on the TV. No matter where you
Hello.
Go, you might see me.
I'm Yeezy. She said, hi, I'm Maria. No, you an angel. You wave hi to Aaliyah. I got a show in Korea. They built a new arena. Why don't you come and watch a nigga tear the whole scene up? I know I seen you before, but don't know where I seen you. Oh, I remember now. You're something that I dreamed of. Go to her head. No, not my Aaliyah. The height of her shopping was writers blocking me. I couldn't get my shit out anyway. I hope you die, Aaliyah.
No, I'm starting to know Kanye now.
Hey? Yeah.
I love that falsetto. That's great. That was fucking great.
Yeah.
The guitar, everything about it was crazy, right?
Yeah. That's the one track that kind of stands out a little bit. Like,
yeah.
It's not, doesn't have the same exact feel as the rest of the album,
yeah.
But it's I fucking love that song.
That's what's great about when somebody does this, an artist does this, and they inject something in that's different. Because if every song is the same vein, right, and it's just sort of like whatever, and then it's like that just hit you from coming from that song and then to this song is just like really good, right? One of the I'm asking everybody out there too, because you guys probably know a lot more than I would about. When you have a guest like Kanye West come on, right,
mm-hmm.
and he writes a verse, or you get him, hey, do a verse for me. Is there a communication that says, hey, you gotta write this in the vein of the rest of the context of the song?
I can't say something 100% because I'm not Kanye West, I'm not Kid Cudi, but I would say I'm almost positive that is the case.
Yeah,
Cudi would approach Kanye and say, hey, I'm talking about the story of this woman or whatever, and I need you to write a verse that's somewhat
okay
tied together.
Yeah, because I got that feeling, right?
Yeah,
like it's there, it was tied to the rest of the song.
It wouldn't make sense if he came in rapping about something totally different,
totally
right?
Politics or
exactly.
No, it was a really, really fun song.
Yeah.
Cudi is, if you're watching Cudi, I need a a hook.
Okay.
I want to be, what is it called? An industry plant?
Yeah. Our goal is to make you an industry plant.
Yeah.
So we'll get Cudi featured on your first first record.
I'm excited.
We'll reach out to him.
Yeah.
And then we'll promote you on TikTok. We'll make a sob story. My name's Kevin. I'm from the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. I've got really old testicles.
Next track is titled Wildin' 'Cause I'm Young.
Wow. This is different.
Yeah.
I be wildin' 'cause I'm young, wildin' 'cause I'm young. Wildin' 'cause I'm young, wildin' 'cause I'm young. I be wildin' 'cause I'm young, I be wildin' 'cause I'm young. And I be wildin' till I'm chillin' old. Wildin' 'cause I'm young, wildin' 'cause I'm young. Wildin' 'cause I'm young, I be wildin' 'cause I'm young. I be wildin' 'cause I'm young.
There's some really crazy shit in the background, eh?
Weird sounds going on.
Yeah, like dark, dark, dark.
So much goose, I let the fire soak it up some. Tuesday weekly, the legend of the rager. Most have witnessed the cut in the club. Tired of hoes, all they want is to get chose. Know the code, want a woman with some toes. Optimals, taking trips to Australia. Do some blow and hope you make it through the show. Hands high, go with your soul. Try floating through the sky.
Okay.
That is a hypnotic track.
Very hypnotic.
Like it was zoning me out. Like,
yeah, just the way the drums and percussion and stuff.
And just everything was just like, and then that dark, I don't know if it's like, I'm going to say dark cowboy feel, like from an old cowboy movie, that weird, that sound that in the background is just like.
No, you totally nailed it on the head with that reference there. It gives me like a. I mean, the vocals are nothing like it, but just the sound of the track reminds me, like, it's in the same vein of Planet Caravan in a way.
Yes. Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
You know, the creepy. That's off Black Sabbath?
Black Sabbath Paranoid?
Doesn't sound anything like it, but it's got that kind of feeling to it.
Yeah. That, I don't know how to explain that.
No.
It's just a feeling. You just feel it. It's weird, right?
Track number. Don't know. I lost track of what we're at number-wise, but we're going into the mood.
Yep.
It's a little trippy right up there.
Yeah. Glad I didn't know.
Shades over my eyes make the creepers look back at themselves. Sitting stuck in emotional bliss. The skinny model girls rub coke on the gums. Tap my knee, I'm keeping the rhythm. The young and wild take chances together. They all jump up, twist and groove. But no one talks, lost in the motherfucking mood. No one talks, lost in the mood.
That guy, is it a guy free? Let's talk
about
it.
Lost in the mood. There's a hunger in the night. The moonlight kissing the nips on the model frame. No one talks, sweating it out. Lost in the mood.
Okay, and that's the mood.
That was trippy.
It's very a short, trippy track.
Short, trippy track. You know, I like the track. Cool track. It was very trippy and what was I just gonna say? I had all these things. See, I gotta write notes or something like that. But one thing I was gonna say is that on this album, all the Cudi fans, I'm not gonna include myself in that because I haven't been through the whole thing yet, right?
Yeah, his whole discography.
Yeah. But this one, is there such an emotional connect as Man on the Moon? Because there is more. Obviously, there's more distance from the listener in terms of, like, he's, you know, with the prostitute
models
and all that kind of and cocaine and all that kind of stuff. Is it a little bit more disjointed from that, you know what I mean?
This album here, I'll say, doesn't give me the same comfort that the first one does. I listened to the first one and it gives me that, like, it's like I said before, it's like having a nice hug from somebody.
Yeah.
Whereas this one is like, if I'm feeling if I'm feeling like really down, I'll listen to this one instead. And and you know, obviously I'm not going to resonate with the, you know, naked models and cocaine and all that stuff and drinking the Grey Goose, but there's still stuff that I can connect with on this.
Yeah.
And it's a very cohesive album too, you know, everything kind of flows very mm-hmm. well.
Yeah.
So it still gives you that comfort, and you'll see there's some more tracks that come on later on that are like this one. If I was having a mental breakdown, I'm not going to listen to The Mood, you know?
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Like, it's
yeah.
not my Cuddy song that I'm going to go to.
Yeah.
But it still, it fits the album well, and it's good. We'll go into the next track, Maniac.
I know why it's giving me some kind of weird shiver. That sound.
Yeah. I swear to tell the truth. The whole truth.
Is this the St. Vincent there?
Yeah.
Because I recognize the voice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. I am the maniac. I am the ghoul. I'm in the shadows in the corner of my room. There's a cape. I love the dog. Maybe we can make it darker. Give me a marker.
Wow, this is totally different, eh? This chorus.
In me when I lost my cool, it lives inside of me, eating what's in its way. I put black spray paint on my windows during the day. I wanna spend time with it.
First time I heard the chorus, it was like I didn't get it. Now I get it. It's weird. Wow, some really different choices of sounds, eh?
Yes, yeah.
Really different stuff going on in there, man. That chorus is, like I just said in there, it's at the first, I was waiting for one of the big Cuddy
choruses,
right? Something I was going to be hooked and blah, blah, blah. And then I'm like, I heard it the first time and I'm like, oh man, that's strange, you know?
The second time it came around.
It's weird. Then the second time it came around, I'm like, as soon as it said the first I Am the Maniac, I'm like, fuck, I get it.
I love how it comes in.
With yes. Yes. Yeah.
And then I Am the Maniac.
Yes. The first time it was like, I was like, no, it just doesn't work in with it. Then the second time.
Okay. Let's go. Mr. Rager.
I'm off on the adventure.
Well, good. This is dedicated to all the kids like me. Whoever you are.
Oh, I like that. This is a really cool track.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm loving the bass and the way.
In this bass here before the chorus.
Oh, yeah. Here I just want to say quickly, when on I'm Off on an Adventure, when they do that in that chorus there, it's one of those stimulating ASMR feelings.
Yeah,
it's so nice, and
because it's so
it's just
fun.
Yes, and it's deep. Yeah, he's doing a deep.
Hey, Mr. Rager.
There. Yeah. Oh, see, that's so good. I just got shivers on that one.
It's beautiful.
So many great things on this track.
Okay, let's hear.
Okay, one. I love right here when. Okay, I'll start up just on the "I'm off on an adventure" part. Those in the brackets here in the lyrics when they sing "Oh, phone it," that they're stimulating to the ears.
Yeah,
and I'm on my way to heaven. Then on certain Mr. Ragers where he sings and he goes up, especially in the second chorus, he goes up and it's so nice when he. I want to hear him. I want to hear, and I don't know if we get to hear it later on in this adventure of on Cuddy, but if he when he goes up and sings, like because I can feel
that he can sing.
I can feel he can sing, and I don't know if you're hiding something from me later on in the game, but he can. He's got that tone. You can hear it. It's in there. It's waiting to come out, right?
And it's such a unique tone too.
It's such a unique tone. He's got a little bit of I think he can do anything. He could do voiceovers for. Anything like he's got that tone, he could sing, he's just that was a really cool track.
Next track is titled "These Worries," and it's got a feature again, Mary J. Blige.
Oh, Mary,
yeah. So,
I like Mary.
Here we go.
You ever heard her sing U2's one with U2?
No, I haven't.
One, right?
Yeah, song?
She sang it on the Grammy Awards. Oh my god, I had
goosebumps.
Goosebumps everywhere for like 2 weeks.
I think that's something else. sounds like a rash or something.
I did go see the dermatologist.
Yeah, the crazy, the wizard, so much whiskey all in my liver. I really like the punch it delivers. Makes me warm while I high five sinners. All alone trying to hide from the shadows. These worries are
Oh, I love Mary's voice. I tell you. Wow, I like this track. I really, really do like this track.
Yeah, you didn't say too much during the song.
No,
I'm assuming you were.
I was just really, really diving deep into it, man. It was everything fucking about this song is good, man. But it just makes me. I'm tired of those motherfuckers saying that they worry about me when in fact they're probably never give a fuck about me.
Yeah.
Just thinking of all the stuff going on with him on this album and the shit he was going through, right? But it's really heavy, heavy duty lyrics. And Mary has this knack of her voice and her tonality, the way she sings, it brings this empowerment to whatever you're saying, like really strong power. So when she's singing that with these, when she says these worries are heavy, they rest on my shoulders, you really feel it.
Yeah. Next track, it's titled the End. It's not the end of the album.
Oh, good. Okay.
But we're close to the end.
No, I'm enjoying this. I want to keep going.
But it's not the end. But the track's called The End. It's featuring GLC and Chip the Ripper.
Chip was on...
He was on the first Man on the Moon. Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, you liked his voice.
I liked his voice, yeah. And he's... Yeah. Wait, Chip the Ripper is from Cleveland.
Yeah. Fuck, you're good at this.
I remember.
Yeah. So, and the chorus is by Nicole Ray.
That intro reminded me of, I don't, Snow.
This is the end. I never
snow,
like cold, like weird, weird.
Interesting.
It was the it sounded like wind or something at the beginning.
Yeah.
Time ago, don't focus where you're being, G, focus where you're trying to go. I swear the game make you cold like a bomino. Snowman, old man, when you're trying to shine like gold. When
feeling, thinking about how I came up from nothing while I'm splitting this cigarello. Phone rings, I get a call, one of my dogs tripping hard, talking about really killing them all. I
say,
slow down, what the fuck you mean? Nigga just ran in your crib and popped your daughter in the spleen. I'll be there in 20 minutes. Phone drop shit, the nigga with something to lose, just almost lost it, won't trust him again.
I like him.
Chip?
Yeah.
Yeah, I love Chip.
Came through at three, saluted ease. Here, supply the weed, cause I've been at OD. It's me with a black rock star steez, real rock tees, 300 a pop for these. Please, buy me, you don't know me, money, day and night get flipped, and I get blow for a grip. I'm caught, I am.
I like
it's
that.
Something like a spiritual healer that can end me. I think that's the part I find intriguing. I'm fiending.
I never do it again. Okay, that's the end.
Is it?
Of the track.
I'm just
not the album.
I'm just getting you going. I'm really wondering. I really like the I really like King Chip.
Yeah. Oh, it's King Chip there. That's his newer rapper name. I guess Genius, where I printed the lyrics, put it as that. But on this album, he was going as Chip the Ripper.
Oh, Chip the Ripper. Okay.
Yeah, but that's his new name.
Okay, that's the same guy from Cleveland from the other
album. From the other
album. Well, I don't know what I like about him. I like, you know what I mean?
He's got a great voice.
He's got a great voice, and he's done some say just, it's like, this, did that, I wonder if this shit really happened that he's talking about. This whole setup.
I would assume so.
Wow.
I mean, I don't, usually you don't want to lie in your.
Yeah, no, that's not.
Music. No, it's.
No, it's not like, you know, like fantasy songs. You make up some kind of fantasy.
No,
thing,
yeah. Third last track.
Well.
Is titled All Along the Watchtower.
I was
no.
Yeah.
No. Just All Along.
It's a cover version.
Yeah. Let's get into it.
Hey. The days change. So does my attitude. At home, I ate a lot of junk food. When the nights change, so do my nightmares too. All along, I guess I'm meant to be alone. All along, all along, I guess I'm meant to be alone.
Well, he's really putting out feelings here, right?
Yeah.
But just you can feel it. Then.
Yeah. When the weeks change, the rumors change too. I guess I'm meant to be.
I love how these choruses built to the orchestration now, eh?
Yeah.
Oh, that's freaking beautiful. That's that cello.
Yeah.
So melancholy. Cellos are never happy.
No, I haven't heard a happy cello.
You can't, you know, somebody's playing a cello, you don't go, look at this party.
Yeah.
Right? Cellos are just like, oh man, this is brutal.
But
he threw it all out there on this track.
Yeah, I was going to say, that's All Along. How do you feel?
I feel sad.
Yeah,
I really do.
It is a sad song.
It's a very sad song, and it's very just throwing out your feelings, you know, of what he's feeling. And it's sometimes it's hard to read like people's lyrics, you know what I mean? Because you get an idea of what they're going through,
mm-hmm.
and it's like you know, I know the backstory of him feeling with his issues and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And it's just like, it hurts.
It does, yeah.
It does hurt because you know that other people are going through this stuff and it's...
I think that's why so many people resonate with Kid Cudi.
Yeah.
It's because, you know, you listen to this and it's hard to find other artists that are doing the same, you know,
throwing it out there?
Throwing it out there that raw and that unfiltered and just how it is. Second last track. It's titled Ghost.
Wow. All right, love the instrumentation already, man. It's, there's nothing I don't like here.
Yeah. My name is Scott Mastin. People I've met and the places I've been all will make me the man I so proudly am. But I want to know one thing. I'm a ghost. Most confused about the world I live in. You think that I'm lonely when I probably am.
No, I like this track.
Things do come around. Some things still trouble me.
Well, that was cool. His voice is wicked, man. Sounds like such an old school piano. I love it.
Yeah.
In someone's living room against a wall.
Okay, and that's Ghost.
I like that track. It is, it really speaks of him. If I'm just thinking this way, but it speaks about him like sort of disappearing and not being seen and that whole, I mean, not just the ghost thing, but just in relationships and the world. And I've got to say, I'll go upstairs and I'll try to write a chorus like
something abstract,
abstract, or one of these really catchy, cutty choruses. It's fucking hard.
Yeah.
Like really, and he comes up with a bunch of them. Like it's not just one, and he cheats and repeats it.
No, yeah.
Every chorus is different, and it's great in its own way. It's like he is the chorus factory. He's the hook king.
Yeah.
Right.
Track number 17.
Well,
it's titled "Trapped in My Mind." A cool story that I learned. I think Cuddy said in an interview. But correct me if I'm wrong, because maybe I'm just totally wrong and I'd heard this somewhere else, but the album was supposed to finish at All Along.
Mm-hmm.
But he felt it would have been too depressing to end it on that song.
Yeah.
So he added Ghost and this song
to close really?
It out. Yeah.
Okay.
Which makes sense because All Along was pretty depressing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So that's what I heard. I forget where I heard it, but if I'm right, let me know.
If he's wrong, let him know.
Yeah. Anyway, track number 17, Trapped in My Mind.
That sounds like the mind, doesn't it?
Yeah.
That? This is cool.
Say I'm trapped in my mind, no, I'm going tripping. Oh, I don't think I'll ever go. See, the walls are so high that I couldn't climb them.
I like these lyrics.
Yeah.
See, when they, oh my God, they come into this interlude.
Yeah.
It just becomes so clean.
Yeah.
And then they took that distorted guitar away and it's just this nice, oh, just beautiful.
See,
that is a good track to end the album.
Totally, yeah, right? I agree.
Like, it really, really, really works, man. It's again, it's like other certain songs that we listen to, Cuddy. I can really relate to this song.
Mm-hmm.
I can really
being trapped in your own mind.
Yeah, just getting trapped and overthinking and crazy thoughts all the time. Obsessive thoughts, and you know, it's really, really, it hits home. This song, right?
Yeah.
The chorus is so infectious, man. It's I gotta get cream. Like, seriously. I gotta see the dermatologist. It's really infectious. Again, it's just, I just want to sing. I was holding back so hard not to sing in this microphone.
Yeah.
Like,
all right. No, I love the way he ended off this album, because like I was saying, with if he ended it on All Along, I think we would have just sat here and looked at each other and be like, fuck, that was sad. I mean, this is still sad, but it's like, it's the, I like the, hey, it's not that bad at all.
Well, exactly. It's melancholy, but it's fucking really, really good. And
yeah,
it's not like it's not the weird, like, he's got a knack for doing that, right? Of making like, you know what I mean? This great melody and stuff like that. And then but there's really an underlying, oh fuck, you know,
yeah,
like it's something going on, but it's like, that's a talent to do that, man. It's like, this is a really good album.
You like it?
Yeah, it's a really good album. Yeah. And I'm a Cuddy fan now. So, you know, it's everything it's, I hear is just like, it's exciting. You know what I mean? It really is, because, yeah. And I know to everybody watching, it's like, you guys heard this shit a long, long time ago. And it's like, it just dropped today for me.
You, yeah.
So it's, I don't know. It's exciting every day. And I can't tell you how I love putting the headphones on and listening to it. And then I spend a couple of days later listening to it again. And then I just go, okay, I'm going to add this on my Spotify, right?
Playlist,
and
yeah,
then add to my playlist. So.
Well, one thing I can say, I'm very jealous or envious of you is...
That
is
here?
Woo! No. Not at all.
You shouldn't be now.
This came out, or first one came out 2009.
Yeah.
This one came out 2010. I loved it when it came out in 2010. I was listening to it. And then he announced Man on the Moon 3 was coming out soon.
Yeah.
I had to wait 10 fucking years for that record to come out.
Was it really?
He released, after this was a rock project, psychedelic yeah. rock.
Are we listening to that or no? No.
Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Then he released a solo record, an EP, a grunge album, which is...
Jeez.
Yeah, that one's... most people aren't like the biggest fans of it, but yeah. I respect it. I like, I enjoy how much emotion he put into it.
Yeah.
Then he came back with another album, which was great. And then he did his Kanye collab album. Then finally, 2020, December, he did Man on the Moon 3.
That's how
so I was like, waiting for 10 years for that record.
And I'm waiting what?
We'll probably do it next month. So
I'm on the Cuddy train.
Yeah, that's it. Check out the Patreon if you can afford it. We really appreciate it. And I appreciate all the support and the kind messages. And he loves them on Instagram.
I love them. Just send them in. I respond to everybody who sends one in.
Yeah. See, I'm not as good as him. On Twitter, I'm slow. I get to everybody, but it takes a while. But you seem to be pretty on the ball when it comes to Instagram. So
I'm weird that way.
Yeah.
So no, I'll stay up till 3 o'clock in the morning messaging everybody around the world.
I have a job outside of doing YouTube. So
yeah, yeah. And he's basically saying, I don't, but I'm at home consulting people,
the Instagram followers.
Yeah.
Anyway, thank you guys for watching. If you made it all the way to the end, I love you, and we'll see you next week with another album.